Hey, what's up everyone? Tankenstein here. In this video, I've got all the information you need in gameplay for the Bussard, a rank 5 BR 3.7 German coastal vessel which acts as the top level naval reward for summer landing. This is again a BR 3.7 ship, and it's pretty much the same as the Albatross currently in game, which sits more or less kind of beside it, except that it has 4 machine guns. That's really about it. So they do offer some level of automated protection versus whether air or ground, typically small torpedo boats. It will do some damage too, but that's about it. Now, one interesting thing that you'll see here is that this is a rank 5 BR 3.7 ship, whereas the Aviaire, right, the level 1 reward for this is a BR 4.0. Now, one could argue the rank is lower, coastal vessels maybe their overall ceiling for BRs is lower, so maybe that's why, you know, it's got a higher rank but lower BR. But I just find that really, really odd that we have the Bussard, the rank 5, right? This is the top level naval reward. I think like last year was the USS Baltimore, right? Ridiculous, crazy ship. And they're giving us the Bussard. Like, what? It's not a bad ship. And I think that its BR will increase over time for two main reasons, or for one big reason. And I'll get to that in just a second. But this has no armor. It's got two pretty decent torpedoes. They're not incredible. The seal torpedoes are okay. You know, I mean, it's 250 kilograms of explosive force, 20 kilometer distance, 61 kilometer per hour top speed. It's pretty good. Not amazing, pretty good. I'd say like 6 or 7 out of 10, right? Not incredible, but good. Now, those will pretty much take care of anything that you'll face when playing ships in the Bussard at current level. It's got zero armor. See, no armor protection for this vehicle. I mean, you have wood, I guess, but that's it. Interestingly, it does not model the HMGs. So there are normally HMGs here. You know, so if you ever get into a match, you'll see they're here. And this is more or less the exact model for the Albatross. I'm not really sure if they're going to change this. Also, if you hear that, there's thunder going on because there's some nasty storm going on outside. But the main reason why I think that this might see an increase in BR is because of these bad boys right back here. These are Exocet anti-ship missile launchers. So I think ultimately the Bussard might get itself a pretty big increase in battle rating. One, because of that, and two, because it has the radar. And I'm guessing that radar, now I'm not really sure how Exocets work, so, you know, I'm not sure if they're radar guided or what. But this would make sense that right now, being that Exocets are not currently in game, it sits at 3.7, whatever. But granted, Exocets do get in game. This could get a major BR increase, and especially if they work them into this design. I mean, the launchers are already here. It could see a major BR increase, which could make it very usable in mid tiers, which would be pretty good, mid BR. So, I mean, this could be a really good ship. I think it's got a lot of potential, but right now it's just, there's not much to it. And also, it's naval. Unfortunately, this Gaijin is not the way to get people into naval. When last year, or one of the last events, we had the Baltimore, and then this time we have a 3.7 BR ship, whereas as the top level naval reward, whereas the previous ship, the 5-star reward instead of the 10-star reward is what, 4.0 or 4.3? Like, come on, guys. Come on. Anyways, let's get into some matches. I know that you guys all love naval, so I'll just kind of jump into it now, but well, let's do it. Now, I'm not like a big fan of how Gaijin kind of handles naval, at least as of right now, when it comes to coastal vessels, because this thing, you can just punch a hole through. I mean, like, you could probably, okay, I mean, really not, but, you know, I mean, you could probably take, like, a power drill and, like, start a flood that would eventually sink this ship, at least if you put enough holes in it, maybe, like, 10 or 20 holes along the side. And I'm just saying, like, it's that thin of armor, and they're putting you within about, what, 2 kilometers range, typically, if you're a coastal vessel, to fight. And it's cool, I guess. But at the same token, it's just like, I mean, I'm not sure what the repair is on this, and I'll go ahead and check that for you maybe after this match. But, I mean, there's a lot of people out there that simply do not have the funds to continually repair vehicles, especially in naval. I've heard some naval vehicles are just, or ships, are just absolutely ridiculous when it comes to repair bills. And unfortunately, I neglected to look at that because, I mean, I don't know if you guys saw, but I got like 14.5 million silver lions. It's not so much of an issue with me right now, but who knows? Who knows? Maybe in the future it could be. You know, and even if it's not an issue with me, I'm, what, one out of tens of thousands of people that play this game on a regular or semi-regular basis. So what if I don't have that problem? A lot of people do. I get reports or requests about that all the time. So it's like, you know, this gets put into like these really close ranges, and albeit I'm not really doing myself a favor here, but I'm also not seeing anyone. I do not see a single enemy. So it's like, I can have a torpedo boat roll up on me right now, fire me with a bunch of HMGs, or like pepper me with a bunch of HMGs, and I'm dead. That's it. Gone. Toast. Hasta la vista, you know? So, anyways. All that lecturing aside. Ooh, I see an enemy. He's 7 kilometers away. Let's see if my autocannon can reach him. Oh, yes, please. Speaking of getting peppered. I do not want to go out of this little loop here. Nor do I want to hit. Okay. That might be a few hits. It's not a few hits. In fact, that's not even one hit. That's even worse than not a few hits. Okay, yes, let's just continually aim low. Yes! These autocannons can be nasty. Don't get me wrong, but I'm also facing torpedo boats. Versus bigger ships, they leave some things to be desired. Is he firing torpedoes at me? Oh, that's a big boat. Okay. I can't do anything to him. Okay, then. Well, this sucks. May as well just bow out now. Torpedo! I'm not gonna bow out. I'm gonna still fight this, but like, damn, son. They have me fighting him? I guess it was bound to happen. Yep, not enough for repairs. Okay, that makes sense. Okay, I'm going to try to get into, I have another vehicle, like a backup. If I do well enough, I'm going to show you guys that. If I do not do well enough, I'm going to go to the next match. So you'll know how well I did by if I'm still in this match in a few seconds. Okay, so it turns out my cannons actually have a quite decent range. I just hit this guy out there. And so that's good, especially considering that these are auto cannons. But what's I'm getting some nice hits. Okay. But I also thought he'd be moving a little bit more than he is. The problem with these, much like any auto cannon, especially ship auto cannons, is that it's not that they're not incredibly easy to overheat, but they take a long time to not to like underheat. Okay, that doesn't make any sense. To lose heat, really. And that is a huge, huge problem that, like, other semi-fast repeating ships do not have. Destroyers, for example, do not have that issue because their guns are not that fast. They're still very powerful and still pretty quick. They just don't overheat. These are mainly good for small ships, not destroyers, because as you can see, despite probably, what, a dozen hits, maybe more, I'm not really doing too much to it. Unfortunately, oh, that got some nice hits. Oh, that's another thing. I don't have any more ammo. Okay. And bear in mind, I went with a full loadout. So I guess you really cannot afford to just throw your ammunition around all willy-nilly. So bear that in mind, because this does not have a ton of ammo. Okay, is he gonna die? Okay. Guess he died. Okay, and now I have to go to the B point. Oh boy. I'm not going to the D point. In fact, actually, now I'm gonna die. So it was good knowing you guys. Now I have to start firing my proximity shells at this guy. Try to hit various parts of the ship. Okay. Oh, that's good. My first age ammunition's gone, I think. What is this guy doing? Oh my gosh. Hey, yeah, let's just pack enough ammunition to make like 80% of it fast or rapid fire. So if you're in a long-term fight, you don't have enough really to complete it. That makes total sense. Ooh, buddy. Come on. Oh, nice. Come on. Nice. One more. Bring it home. Don't bring it home. Okay, I'm like... There we go. There we go. Okay, now I can go back to the B point. Get me some ammunition. Hope that we can win this. Okay, that was pretty good. I thought, honestly, that I would not be able to, I really don't know why that guy did not attack me. Why that destroyer did not attack me? I have no clue. Oh, ooh. Whoop, 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 whoop. This is the opposite of good. Wait a second. That's a small enough ship. Nice. See, now those LMGs actually do serve a purpose. They don't do too much, but they do help a little bit. So there's that. Now I've got 13 shots on an autocannon. And I'm going into an active fight. So do I think I'm going to win this? I don't know. It's possible, I suppose. I've got 78% of my crew. I'm guessing the other crew is just loaded up into those Exocet missile launchers. Could be. This has a pretty hefty top speed, 76 kilometers per hour. I believe the real Exocets were thereabouts that. They were like 74, or not Exocets. Whatever class this is, the Bussard class or whatever. They were about that. I think it was like 74, 75 maybe. But yeah, I mean, I've got myself some nice radar. I can see things all around me. But yeah, I'm going to get me some ammunition now. Because this is unsustainable. That's not a good sign. That's a really bad sign. Okay. He just went up in a cloud of smoke. Okay. That's not an enemy ship. That's an enemy ship. Oh, that's not good. That's a pretty big enemy ship, too. Hey, I think that's me. No, that's not me. That's somebody who just died. You can shoot at me, but I won't shoot back. Literally because I have got almost no ammunition. Oh, God. You better not come over here, son. I need this ammo. Oh no, he's going for it. He's going for it. I literally can't do anything. I've run it. And I went into this battle with a full load of ammunition. That's crazy. Anyways, let's get into the next match. I'm not going to really be playing too much more. Naval's too slow. They're 9 kilometers away. Like, that's the range that they can hit you and will hit you. And then you can waste all your ammunition trying to hit them. So why would I want to do that? Let's see. Does it even tell me, like, when my shots are going to hit? No, because the cannons are not big enough. There's still a lot of work to be done on Naval. Like, what's the point of bringing a ship that's pretty much a clone of a ship in-game, except... Oh, look, you have a few guys arming there in-game. So, in a match, they're there with their MGs. But in the shipyard, they are not. I don't know. It just doesn't really make a ton of sense to me. Okay, let's do this. Okay, there goes my ship. Like, what the crap? What the crap? Okay. Okay, I'm doing another match. That was stupid. Okay, I'm in a total up tier. That's fun. So that last match that I played, where I was alive for a few seconds and then I died because my crew just blew up. After that, I decided, you know what? I'm going to keep in this match. I'm going to try the M802. The M802 is a premium German ship. Since it's 3.3 BR, I believe in both AB and RB, which is important because it's give or take around 50% split based on a poll I ran. So that said, the M802, much less advanced. I mean, it was from the 40s. It was a, you know, World War II era ship for the Germans. And I annihilated people. I couldn't imagine how the Albatross is, being that it has no secondary armaments. But I annihilated people. I mean, outside of the torpedoes, of course. Annihilated them. They came close to my ship. They got torn apart. Those 105mm cannons absolutely goofed. Goofed the enemy. Like, I don't know. The Bussard, I feel like, is okay. It's not bad. But, like, it has... no, hardly any ammunition. Like, this thing runs out of ammo. You've seen it. Within the space of about, what, minute and a half, maybe 2 minutes of firing, give or take. That's not good. Ooh, it's a Jaguar class. Ooh, I got him. Got him. But it is good when trying to take out small boats. Okay, there's a missile. Missiles are bad. Okay. You know what else is bad? Having the worst gunners in the world. What is going on? Okay, there we go. It doesn't even matter. What? Okay, one more match. This is dumb. So one thing I've learned about this ship, and it's probably much the same with the Albatross, is that the cannons are extremely susceptible to being killed. You will go from having offensive capability to zero capability in about 5 seconds with well-placed shots, probably even less. So let me know, I mean, what you guys think. If am I bad at Naval? I mean, I think I'm pretty good at most things in this game. Decent at RB, especially when it comes to RB ground. Damn good at AB air. I'm really good at AB air. I love playing some AB air. But when it comes to Naval, what is it? I'm missing, like, all my shots with this thing, even though I'm aiming directly at these people. So let me know in the comments below, am I trash? I don't know. I don't know. Oh, God. Any enemy. That's enough for me to cringe. Oh, God. What is going on? Holy guac. Oh, my God. There's a hidden enemy or something. Like, what? You see that? You see how much crew I lost in 8 seconds, probably? Give or take around 8 seconds. Man. I could have been smarter with that, sure, but a large part of these test drives is to show you the capabilities and also the deficits from these vehicles. And I mean, there are some major deficits. Like the fact that I can't shoot newly spawned vehicles. And that they can shoot me. No. Okay, good. Good, 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 good. Not good. Not good. Now good. Okay, I'll take the assist. Oh god, one of those things. The Soviet sub of doom. Okay, I'll say this. This vehicle is, at least in AB, extremely fast. Even in RB, it's very, very quick. Obviously, AB kind of enhances that a little bit in some regards, which is certainly nice. Okay, he's coming over. Come on, let's see my gunners actually make a few shots here. They aren't. What? Come on! What did I do to deserve this? Come on. Let me get some shots. Let me get some hits. Or not. I guess no hits. That's fine. Okay. I get that thing's armored, but damn, man. Ah, the Bussard. The Bussard. This is... Again, maybe I suck. I don't know. Maybe I suck. I just can't tell. But man, this is an underwhelming top level vehicle. We had the Baltimore, and now we have the Bussard. So, either way, that's it. I'm not going to try any more of this. Please like, comment, subscribe. You know the deal. Hopefully, Naval ends up getting better. But, yeah. I guess I'll see you guys all on the other side. Take care, everyone.